Too bad those green slimes aren't jello shots.
Oh my god.
It is down to you.
That was pretty good.
I don't really have anything to film here, but this is like my favorite part of the... Oh my gosh. Stupid Gildy's making all this noise. Let me switch bench channels here real quick.
There's nothing to explain. You're trying to kidnap what I've rightfully stolen.
Okay, there we go. No more vent noise. So this is like my favorite part of this entire movie. This is the battle of wits between the bald guy and
there can be no arrangement, then we are
the Dread Pirate Roberts.
I'm afraid so. I can't compete with you physically, and you're no match for the grab.
You're that smart.
Let me put it this way. Have you ever heard of Plato?
Yeah. So this scene here, it's totally
Socrates,
awesome. You know, I watch this, I wonder. I think to myself, like, could this happen? Like in real life, was this based on, you know, true events? And you know, I've been watching a lot of MythBusters lately. So I thought to myself, you know, I'm going to test that, you know, scientifically. I'm going to find out if this could really happen, because I mean, the MythBusters they do that kind of stuff. So the first thing I did was I wanted to get my hands on some iocane powder, just, you know, test out its properties. Is it really like odorless and colorless and all that stuff, dissolving instantly in water? And, you know, so the first thing I did is I went to Wikipedia because, you know, that's the source of all knowledge. Can my dilemma resume here real quick? And so I went to Wikipedia and I found this page called List of Fictional Toxins. And much to my dismay, iocane powder is actually fictional. Even in Australia, they don't have any. So that kind of put that one to rest. And I see that Dominic is offline. That is not very great.
Where is the poison? The battle of wits has begun.
And see, another thing I was really curious about this scene here is the Dread Pirate Roberts. He's faced with this situation, and you know, he decides he wants to do a battle of wits, and he just produces this vial of fictional toxin. What the hell was it doing in his pocket anyway? Was he like getting dressed in the morning? And you know, he got his wallet and his keys and you know, maybe his cell phone, and then on the dresser there it's like, oh yeah, my iocane. I might need that today. I'm gonna go ahead and put that in my breast pocket. So yeah, I just wanted to kind of share my feelings with this scene.
Because iocane comes from Australia, as everyone knows.
I hope you enjoy the scene as well. I'm gonna go ahead and cut traps here so I can pay attention to this fight. It's going to be hard with only 9 people. Okay, here comes the best part. Oh, you fool. Classic blunder.
It's on me.
Only slightly less well known is this. Never go in against a Sicilian when death is on the line.
Just swing by her.
Oh, stupid Sicilian.
I will if you say I get to
open. Oh, man. Can't believe he tried to beat the Dread Pirates Robert by switching cups. As if he would fall for something so stupid as that. Gah, these people.
Who are you?
I'm known to be trifled with.
That's where I am too. I'm known to be trifled with. Oh.
Bunch of honestly.
Wow, that was amazing. Like, we're going along fighting.
They
the blood
did
princes.
Claim to fix that.
And,
a,
you know, I hope you saw somewhere. That. But we're fighting the Blood Princes, we're doing awesome because we're awesome, and you know, I'm healing away, and then suddenly this rogue just shadow steps behind me and kills me in one shot. And see, look here, I'm dead. You can see
wow.
I'm dead. And I'm like, what the hell? There's no rogues in the Blood Princes. Wow. Is this like, you know, super hard mode? And apparently one of those, you know, fire things exploded on the ceiling and aggroed the people way up there. They came. They
and
ran
make sure
all
you
right
in there that you murder them in their sleep.
Ran through this, you know, solid concrete or, you know, whatever kind of door that is. Some kind of, you know, advanced polyurethane or something. Just sauntered right through it, like it had, you know, no density at all, just zero density. They just walked through it, and then just, you know, shadow stepping all the healers and stuff. What is that? God, oh, man, stupid. So I've just realized that I've already filmed about 14 minutes worth of stuff, and it's good stuff. I mean, 14 minutes of me talking. I can't think of any better way to spend 14 minutes. But unfortunately, YouTube has a 10-minute cap on videos. You can't have videos longer than 10 minutes. So, yeah, at first I thought, oh, well, I'll stop filming stuff, and then I'll, you know, edit 4 minutes out. And I was like, no. None of that. I'm just going to make this a two-part episode. So, yeah, we'll see how it goes, how the night progresses. So, here's what I do with my free time. Like Friday nights, when other people go out and drink and do whatever it else is that cool people do. I stand around and wait for Ziva, who spends a lot of time offline. I imagine this is kind of what it's like to, you know, date a real woman, just always waiting for her to do whatever it is she's doing. I don't know. Maybe that's why I've always been single. That's probably the reason. So I've switched my side movie monitor to Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. This is the 1971 version with Gene Wilder. I like the new one. I'm a Johnny Depp fan, but the original one with Gene Wilder is...
Which means it's going to be another 3 months before I get mine.
I learned... As a child, I learned some of my most important lessons from this movie, like, don't watch too much TV, don't eat bubblegum all day.
It will get rolled for, I will lose, and then Matt will drop it.
This might get sucked up by a big tube.
Well, I'll have to roll just to see if I would have won it.
You know, that sort of thing.
No, that's exactly what's going to happen.
And as I'm watching this, I'm wondering, this Candyman song scene. This guy is running the store. He's just passing out all this candy, and I'm not seeing any money change hands. I mean, are all these kids paying for this stuff?
Can you call your ISP?
You know, Charlie's outside looking all sad outside the window because he doesn't have any money. But why don't he just go in there and blend in? And you know, I mean, the Candyman guy is like throwing candy in the air for people to catch. How is he making any money? Yeah, whatever. Where the hell is Ziva? Gosh! And there's not even a space for me in these motorcycles. I hate my life. What the hell? I'm just gonna... who am I kidding? I'm gonna sit here and keep waiting.
We just completed the encounter.
Mr. Turkentine is like the best teacher of any movie ever.
I see what you're saying.
But mixed together in the right way, as only I know how, what do you think it makes?
I don't know, sir.
Of course you don't know.
You don't know, because only I know. If you knew and I didn't know, then you'd be teaching me instead of me teaching you. And for a student to teach his teacher, it's presumptuous and rude. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.